Your app deserves an auth solution that will scale with you from init to IPO. And that's why we made AuthKit. Not only is AuthKit easy to set up for your initial users, it scales with you as you need to onboard enterprise customers. We just released the first major version of our AuthKit Next integration. Let's get into it. So here we have a freshly generated Next.js app. And as of recording, that resolves to Next.js 15 1.6 and React 19. We need to install just one dependency, the @workos.inc/authkit-next.js dependency. I know it's a mouthful. With that installed, run the application to see our progress. Now I'd like to add sign in and sign up buttons right here. So let's jump into the code and we'll create a new section right here. Put a header, an empty link for sign up, and an empty link for sign in. Now we have a few problems already. We need to import link from next link, and these href attributes can't be empty. So we'll fill them with URLs that we get from WorkOS. We get these by calling two asynchronous functions, and this await colors our page function, making it async. All that's left is to import both of these functions from our WorkOS AuthKit Next package. But to know which WorkOS application to link to, we need to set up some environment variables. Fortunately, this is wildly easy in the WorkOS documentation. Under User Management Quick Start, we find our framework and jump to the Set Secrets section. Here, all of our secrets are available with our staging environment API key and client ID. All that's left to do is paste this into a .env file. Now there is one manual change we need to make. We need to supply our own cookie password. We can do this pretty simply by taking the output of the command open SSL rand base 6424. Now our next app knows where to send people on sign up and sign in. I already have a Google account, so I'll say sign in and press this Google button. But we get a redirect error. So what does that mean? Well, let's check the URL, because after we've authenticated, we're getting sent back to localhost 3000/callback with an authentication code. And this matches the URL that we've supplied here as the next public WorkOS redirect URI. But we don't yet have a route handler set up at this callback URL. So in our app directory, create a new callback directory, and in it, a route.ts file. We'll return a get handler using the function handle auth, which we get from our AuthKit Next package. Save this. Jumping over to our logs, we see that we're getting an invalid grant error because this code has already been attempted. So let's try logging in again by navigating back to our root and signing in. Now this code worked, but we're still seeing our sign up and sign in. So let's see if we can add some user data to our page. We get a user by calling the with auth function and destructuring the user from the resulting object. All that's left is to import that function with auth and conditionally render something when we have a user object. Now we get an error informing us that we're calling with auth on a route that isn't covered by AuthKit middleware. Jumping back to the quick start guide, we have middleware documentation here. I'll grab this quick middleware auth snippet here. This middleware file belongs in the root of your application. Simple save should do it. Refresh. And there we are. Welcome back, Michael. Now, while you may hope that a user once logged in will never leave your app, we should give them a way to sign out. Let's jump back to our page component and import one final and very important function, sign out. Now you'll notice that this isn't a URL like these other ones. And that's because we'll actually call this in a server action. We create a sign out button inside of a form that calls an action asynchronously on the server, signing the user out. But does it work? It sure does. Now, there are a few things in the WorkOS dashboard that you need to know. This redirects page is your friend. You'll need to add a redirect URI for the callback URL that's set up in your environment variables. This can be any URI as long as it matches in both places. And finally, you'll want to set up your app homepage. This is where the user is redirected by default when they hit the sign out link. So that's all there is to setting up AuthKit in a Next.js app. In our next video, I'll show you how to use WorkOS widgets to get a full end-to-end user management table inside of your apps with just a few lines of code. It's absolutely insane. So get subscribed if you don't want to miss that. I'm Chantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.